In this blog, we will try to create a Flutter application that supports all the platforms. So like mobile, that is Android and iOS, and web browser. So here we will be testing with the Chrome that can work on any web browser again. And also the third one is a desktop platform. So which includes Windows, Linux and Mac operating systems. So now let's start creating our project. So importing our material.dart file here and initialize with void main. So here we are considering a class my app. Inside the run app we are specifying the class my app, and now we need to create this particular class here. So I'm going to create it as a stateless for now, and here I'm going to return a material app over here. So inside which, in the home tag, I'm going to specify a scaffold, and scaffold will provide all these features for us. So now let us choose some of them. And here inside the scaffold, currently I don't want to take an app bar because I'm developing an application that works on desktop platform as well. So I don't want to have an app bar in a desktop based application. So just for a tutorial sake, and you may add it if you have any requirements. So now inside the body, let us consider one more class home here. So you can specify your code in the body tag itself, but I want to make a clean kind of code, so I'm just specifying it outside. So now this class home also extends a stateless widget here. So here we are getting a container back, but I just want a grid view to be displayed. So here we will try to return a grid view and cross axis count of 2 I'm gonna specify, and here we can specify the children for our grid view and can just align the code. And inside the children I want to specify an icon as a grid. So for which, in the pub spec I'm going to add a dependency flutter underscore icons here. So currently I am not specifying any version here, but you can specify the version when you are building a real-time application. We will be making use of that particular dependency and add icons to our grid view over here. I'm going to consider a card view inside which we gonna specify the required things for us. So in the card view I'm gonna specify a container here so that I can easily have a color on the background. So here you can specify some color for your container. So let's specify the red. You can also specify a child here. So inside the child I'm going to specify an icon. So this particular icon we can make use of our dependency which we have added, and from there font awesome. So here I'm going to add a home icon. So let us try to run and check the output once, how this will appear onto the screen. So here we got the output. The icon is too small and also the color is black. So now let us try to change it. So here when you tap on the icon button here, you can have the whatever the parameters we can pass. So we want to increase the size and also want to change the color. So again coming back, just add a comma over here and specify the size here. And if you are having any queries how you need to specify the size, tap on the size and here you can pass a double value as specified. And here color colors dot white. And now let us try to run our code and see. the color was changed and also the size is reduced. So let us make it 100 and now try to run the code, and yes, our icon is now changed according to the size requirements. So let us make it a 80 so that it looks much better. Okay, so our home icon is now created the help of this particular card here, and also I just want to add some padding over this card, and now I'll try to run the code and see how this will look like. Just want to make some more padding here. In the same way, I want to add few more options to my dashboard here. Copy this particular code from padding and paste this few more times until my screen is loaded with the icons. So yes, in this way I have added 5 different cards other than the home button which we have added. And here now let us try to run the code and see the output here. So this is how our icons will appear in a mobile device that may be Android or iOS. So currently you are seeing the iOS screen. And now let us try to run the code for a desktop application here. So the same code we will be trying to run onto the desktop application. So here, for the first time when you are trying to run the code on a desktop application, you need to make sure that you have added the desktop support for your project here. That is, when you have created a Flutter application, by default you will be not getting the support for the desktop application, but here you need to add it to your project from this particular page here. This is an official Flutter page and I will be providing this link in the description section below, and from there you need to add the desktop support. So it will be adding desktop support for your existing project here. So you need to copy this particular code and move to your Android Studio here. Inside the terminal you need to add this particular command and run it. So I have already added to this particular project and here I am trying to run the code now. And yes, if you still face any problem in adding this particular desktop support to your code, do let me know in the comment section below. And also in our previous tutorial we have discussed in detail how to add desktop support. So here you can see our Mac OS application is now currently in build stage. So here is our Flutter desktop application is now ready. Here you can see our files are being getting synchronized. So here you can see our output. So this is a grid view which we have seen earlier on the iPhone here. So using the same code we have developed an application that works on the desktop, that is Mac operating system here, and also we will see the output on Chrome also, so which will support our web version of the Flutter app. So yes, whenever you are trying to run the code on the Chrome browser, you may find this particular error here showing that to add web support to your project you need to run this particular command. Stating this particular error, this application is not configured to build on the web. Let us copy this particular command and move ahead to the terminal and here try to run this particular command and configure our project to run on the Chrome browser as well. So yes, now our application is being now configured to run on Google Chrome browser here. So it's saying that all done. In order to run your application, type cd flutter run. So yes, now let us try to run our project by typing the command flutter run. So now let us see how this works on our Chrome. So here is the output for the Chrome browser here, and the grid view is being loaded into our Chrome browser in the same way it was loaded into our iOS and desktop version of application. Here you can just scroll down and have a look. And also if you want to make some changes on the Chrome browser here, that is I want to have 4 rows. So now let us see the output once. So here this is the output for our application on the Google Chrome browser. And now in a single frame, we will try to see the outputs of all the applications that run on different platforms. So here this is for web browser, and this is for our desktop application, and here comes our mobile application. These are the three variants of our application which runs on three different platforms. And for this mobile application, it supports iOS and Android. And here for the web browser, it supports different browsers that are available. So desktop, in the sense, it will work on both laptop and desktop. Just I want to make sure and differentiate from these two versions. I have named it as a desktop here. This works on Mac, Windows and Linux operating systems. So here, this is it for this tutorial. And if you are having any queries in the implementation, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you are having any trouble in running your application onto the web browser or the desktop applications, do let me know. And also watch our previous tutorials for Flutter integration and adding desktop support, and do watch our previous tutorials for upgrading your current version to Flutter 2.0 to get the advantage of these three platforms. So this is it for this tutorial. Do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.